Could a worn out spark plug actually help you weld metal right in your own workshop? Let's find out. You probably have a few old spark plugs lying around from your mower, car, or generator. Most people toss them out, but today I'll show you how to turn one into a simple welding tool that really works. No fancy machines, no expensive gear, just a bit of creativity and some basic materials you already have at home. By the end of this video, you'll see how that worn-out plug can hold a welding rod and melt metal just like a store-bought setup. Let's start with the main part, the old spark plug. First, grab one from any small engine or car. Clamp it gently in a vise so it stays steady while you work. Use a wrench or pliers to loosen and remove the metal shell around the porcelain core. You'll notice the inside has a small electrode. We won't need that part, so use a hacksaw or pliers to cut it off cleanly. What you want to keep is the ceramic insulator, the white center section. Next, take a small nail or a thin drill bit and carefully push it through the center of the ceramic core. The goal is to make a straight hole from top to bottom. That's where the welding rod will fit later. Work slowly and avoid cracking the porcelain. Once the hole is clear, take the metal shell you removed earlier and drill a small hole through its side. This hole will be used later for attaching a screw and connecting your power wire. Now it's time to reassemble the parts. Apply a few drops of super glue around the outside of the ceramic piece and press it back into the metal shell. Make sure it's centered and that the hole stays open all the way through. Hold it steady for a minute or two until the glue sets. What you've just made is a solid, heat-resistant sleeve that will hold your welding rod firmly in place while keeping your hands insulated from the heat. The perfect starting point for a homemade welding handle. Let me know where you're tuning in from. I love seeing how far our DIY community reaches. Now let's make the power connection for our homemade welding handle. You'll need two wires, one white and one red, both thick enough to handle the current. Start with the white wire. Strip about an inch of insulation from one end to expose the copper strands. Then slide that bare end into a thin aluminum tube about 2 inches long. Once it's in place, the tube on a firm surface and gently tap it flat with a hammer. This locks the copper wire tightly inside so it won't loosen when the heat builds up. next move to the other end of the aluminum tube. Flatten it as well, then use a small drill bit to make a clean hole near the edge. This hole will later be used for a screw connection to the spark plug body. Make sure the hole is smooth and free of sharp edges so it doesn't cut the wire. This aluminum tube works like a solid bridge between your cable and the metal body of the spark plug. It keeps the connection strong, stable, and heat resistant, perfect for a welding setup. When you're done, your white wire should be fully secured, ready to carry current safely from your power source to your spark plug handle. Now it's time to bring the pieces together and make the actual welding handle. Take the spark plug body you prepared earlier and the aluminum tube with the white wire attached. Line up the small hole on the tube with the hole you drilled in the spark plug shell. Place a small screw through both holes, then secure it tightly with a nut on the other side. This gives you a strong electrical and mechanical connection between the wire and the plug. Make sure everything feels firm but not overly tight. The spark plug should still be able to rotate slightly if needed. Once that's done, take a welding rod and slide it through the hole in the ceramic core. It should pass smoothly from one end to the other without wobbling. That's it, you've just built a simple insulated handle that can hold a welding rod securely. It's compact, sturdy, and completely homemade, ready to connect to power and start welding. Now let's power it up and see what this homemade setup can do. You'll need two 12-volt batteries, the kind used in cars or motorbikes, will work just fine. Place them side by side on a flat, stable surface. Use a red wire to connect the positive terminal of the first battery to the negative terminal of the second. This links them together in series, giving you a total of 24 volts, which is perfect for small welding jobs. Next, take your white wire, the one connected to the spark plug handle, and attach it to the remaining positive terminal. Then take another wire, preferably orange or black, and connect it to the remaining negative terminal. This wire will complete the circuit once you start welding. Make sure all connections are tight and insulated properly before turning anything on. Now grab two small aluminum bars or scrap metal pieces for the test. Clip the orange wire to one piece, and hold your spark plug handle with the welding rod touching the other. The moment the rod makes contact, you'll see a bright spark that's your arc forming. Move the rod slowly along the joint and watch the metal melt and fuse together. The Boogie's ceramic insulator keeps your hands safe from heat and the connection stays solid thanks to the metal shell. In just a few seconds, you'll have a clean, strong weld made completely with a recycled spark plug and two small batteries. Simple, clever, and surprisingly effective. And there you have it, a fully working welding tool made from nothing more than an old spark plug, a few wires, and two small batteries. It's strong, practical, and built completely by hand. Projects like this prove that with a bit of creativity, you can turn almost any scrap part into something useful again. If you enjoyed this build, hit the like button and share it with a friend who loves hands-on projects too. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you won't miss the next clever DIY idea right here on the channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.